Hello and welcome to our new session from the Global Mobility and COVID-19 series. I hope you are all well and still somehow working through the current challenging time. My name is Friederike Ruch and I will be speaking now for the next couple of minutes, telling you what or providing you with an update about the current situation from in Switzerland, as well as then looking or discussing on three examples with you the consequences currently for the payroll. Now the consequences, you will see that in a moment, are still a bit of it. You have to do on a kind of professional or provisional basis, and then maybe at a later stage then also retroactively might have to do some changes. Now, what is the current situation? The current situation is still the government has not decided or has not provided any decision on the borders, meaning the borders are still closed. There's still no change to it. The only change we currently have now is that within Switzerland, some of the shops were able to start yesterday to open again. And I assume you have seen also the one or the other photo in the newspapers or in the news how that worked. We will see in the end, and that is what the Federal Council and the government is also saying, we have to see in the end what impact that has, meaning whether usually people still keep to the distance or keep the distance, as well as staying home as best as possible, and therefore helping as well to keep the number of infected people as low as possible. For Switzerland, still high-risk countries are all Schengen states, as well as all other states, except for Liechtenstein. There is an instruction from the State of Secretary regarding the migration of the audience too. And there it is, and there's no news on it. People who are already in Switzerland, who might be here in Switzerland based on a Schengen visa or on a on an permit card which has expired now, but cannot exit Switzerland, they should notify the migration authority and then they will be allowed to stay in Switzerland. Extensions of work and residence permits for people who are permanently in Switzerland or staying for a longer period in Switzerland, they will still be reviewed and approved. So there is no problem at all. Even the migration authorities or a couple of the authorities have for customers or clients their counters closed, they're still working, at least partly working. For people who are still abroad and for which new work permits have to be applied or have to received, it's still the issue that in principle until the 15th of June, nothing will be reviewed, no work permit or approval will be issued. The one or the other authority which a bit ago said, oh, we might start in May already with reviewing the applications and seeing to it, currently are actually changing their attitude and saying we cannot do anything because the government was there quite strict, but they are saying don't accept any application, you cannot review them until 15th of June. Now there as well, the government said to it, we will have to see how the COVID-19 situation is, and maybe we can lifting up a bit of that ban, or we actually have to even change the date to even more into the summer. For applications which had been filed before the 18th of March, but which had not been fully approved, they are shall be suspended. That is the information from the federal authority. And for anybody, EU EFTA national or non-EU EFTA national, the work permit will not be approved for those, except they are really either people in the need from the mainly from the public interest, or in regard to the health sector. For family reunifications, students and pensioner, at the moment, basically for non-EU EFTA nationals, it's not allowed at all that they can enter Switzerland, and for EU EFTA nationals, it's not recommended. However, the interpretation out of it from the different cantonal authorities is they don't do anything. Schengen and national visas, there is at the moment none will be issued, except now it's really about people who have to travel to Switzerland and work here in Switzerland based on public interest or health or in regard to the health sector, or some exceptional cases. But in principle, you have to somehow work around and see that you can actually work without. In addition, most of the companies have travel bans or travel restrictions, meaning that they in any case say that their employees should stay home and not travel around. Crossing the border, in principle, not all the borders are open, but that has also not really changed in the last few weeks. There are only certain borders open. In principle, everybody should be really or will be checked. And only if somebody has really either the cross-border permit or any Swiss residence permit or is a Swiss national or any other documentations showing that he needs to come to Switzerland for work purposes, then the individual will be let in to Switzerland. Just for tourism or job search or taking up residence, as for example a pensioner or a privateer, that is not possible at the moment. What you also maybe have seen or from German nationals who are have a cross-border permit and have to commute on a daily basis, they are requested to show the document Pendlerbescheinigung, which has to be filled out and signed by the employer, that they can travel on a daily basis or commute and crossing the border on a daily basis. So basically, at the moment, we have still the same situation as I presented last week, at least in regard to foreigners coming to Switzerland or won't have to come to Switzerland. There is no change. We have to see whether next week there might be something new, depending as well then in regard to that the schools should or shall open by the 11th of May, and maybe also then there might be then some new information or a change to the current situation. Looking now at our topic about the payroll consequences. We have the following case. A German national is residing in Konstanz, Germany, and is employed by ABC Consulting LTD in Zurich. He has a valid cross-border permit and is commuting on a daily basis. Due to the current COVID-19 situation, he is now working from home since 1st of March. How does the salary calculation for April look like? On the right-hand side, you see the salary calculation. If we assume now he has a base salary of 8,000 Swiss francs, he has two children, so he gets still the children or child allowance for each kid. And then he, in principle, is subject to the Swiss Social Security, assuming that before he had fully worked in Switzerland, therefore Swiss Social Security contributions are applicable. And those are deducted. Also now in April, even he had been working completely or is working completely in out of Germany, we recommend and suggest to deduct the Swiss Social Security contribution, as well as still deduct the tax at source of 4.5%, which you can deduct for someone commuting on a daily basis. Now, what I said in the beginning, there might be then retroactively that you might have to change the one or the other thing. The current situation or the current status is that the Social Security Authority is saying that for people who are commuting or have been commuting before on a daily basis, and they cannot commute now during the current situation on a daily basis because they are restricted, their Social Security will view it as it had, as the Corona or the COVID-19 situation would actually have not been occurring. So basically also seeing they would commute as before on a daily basis, and therefore the Swiss Social Security contributions will be applicable. So they are not looking at the situation like, okay, that person now has been living or working out of Switzerland for more than 25% maybe, and therefore that this German Social Security will be applicable. As these people only are staying home because of the current restrictions, the authority or the Social Security Administration in Switzerland as well as in Germany are saying they intend that they just will kind of block out the COVID-19 situation and just look as how it was before. If the person before had not been overstepping the 25%, then they just take that as granted for the whole period. The situation is that is the intention from everybody. We have to see in the end what the outcome really is. And therefore, you should definitely keep that in mind, that you check those cases once we can go back maybe to the normal way of working again, when the borders are not closed anymore. And then you have to check with the different involved parties how the situation is. Tax at source, the same thing. The tax administration in Switzerland as well as in Germany, and there the problem is a couple of them in Germany are saying they will treat it as the COVID-19 situation is not really in place, and just as it had been before, and block out that whole thing. But not all tax administration, at least not in Germany, have agreed on it or are saying, yes, we definitely do. So you will have to keep that in mind and review it really at a later stage again. What you definitely should do is to get an A1 for these people, so that in case there is anything in they need to get in Germany or will be reviewed or controlled or checked, that you do have the A1 confirming that the individual is subject to Swiss Social Security contributions. The A1 is a recommendation. It's not really a must. So it's up to you whether you say, okay, good, yes, we do that for our people, or you say, we are so overloaded in work, we do that as a second priority, or only do that for the cases we definitely need to. From my my understanding, my feeling is that we most likely will only know end of the summer, beginning of autumn, most likely, what really will be the different stakeholders doing, and then most likely really have to see whether retroactively we have to do something. Therefore, it is quite important that everybody is tracking where they are in order to see then what the right situation is or what has to be corrected. The second example, a French national is employed by ABC Consulting in Zurich. He is usually living in Zurich, whereas his family lives in Paris, France. Due to the current COVID-19 situation, he moved in March back to France to his family and is working now out of France. How does his calculation look like? If we assume now he has received also 8,000 Swiss francs as the base salary, the child allowance on top of it gives us a total gross salary of 8,400. Now, him working out of France would basically mean that we have to see whether the French social security contributions have to be deducted or might be applicable. As he is not really assigned, he's just working for a Swiss employer, but outside of Switzerland, so in France in this example. The agreement of free movement is here applicable, the EU agreement, and this says that the social security has to be deducted, or the individual has to be enrolled in the social security system in which either the employer is, and if the individual is working from a different EU member state fully, then actually it is that country where the social security contributions have to be paid and the person is subject to that social security system. Now, here again, based on the current situation, the authorities have the intention that they don't want to complicate the situation even more as it is. And basically, they understand as well that they will not benefit from it, that if they, in the end, have employers having to pay social security contributions in the country just for a temporary period. I mean, hopefully, and we all hope that at some point the COVID-19 period is over and that it will not last until the next year. But it depends on the situation. So currently what you need to do is still keep him in the Swiss social security system, deduct the contributions as he would have stayed here in Switzerland, and the same thing as well, deduct the tax at source as it was before. There might be that in the end the individual has to pay French taxes or French income taxes on his income. There is a possibility of it and a risk also. My suggestion is either, I mean, if you want to have it 100% right, then definitely, yes, check it right now already with the French tax partner so that you are sure whether the French taxation will be applicable, yes or no. However, most likely the French tax person will tell you we have to see in the end for how long the individual will definitely work out of France and not working out of Switzerland. And only if the whole situation is known, then it is certain what the consequences also from a tax point of view will be. Due to that, here as well, you may need to check again later this year, meaning as soon as you know that the French employee has returned back to Switzerland, then check whether retroactively you need to change something, or at latest before the year end to see whether any corrections need to be done. Really do the review. Even the situation may last until end of the year. Do a review at latest in autumn, so that at that time point you definitely can still correct something if required. For him as well, it would be recommendable to get the A1 form, so that in case any French authority will check on him, he can show that he's subject to Swiss social security contributions. The third case we have prepared is basically more or less the same. It is now an Austrian national. He is employed by ABC Consulting in Zurich. He wanted to move from Austria to Switzerland. His employment started as of 1st of March, but he actually did not really start, meaning moving to Switzerland. He remained in Austria and never came or never entered Switzerland. In practice, we had a couple of questions about whether you still can employ somebody, even you currently will not get a work permit for somebody not already in Switzerland, and whether you then can also pay salary to that person. To all of this, we can say yes. Yes, it is possible still. I mean, if you had somebody whose employment contract or whose employment relationship started 1st of March, for example, he was not able to enter Switzerland before, he remained abroad, you still can commit to the employment contract. It's then a matter of whether he can really work and to perform some work for you, or whether you in the end have to say, okay, we keep the employment contract, we still pay salary, but maybe he cannot even start to work because he cannot really onboard to the company. And that is a different matter. From a legal point of view, you can have him starting to work, you would pay him the salary, and then also in that situation, what you could do is you can enroll him in the Swiss social security system. However, there, please check with your social security authority whether they allow it. Some of them say they need to have a residence permit or a confirmation that they had been in Switzerland before or are residing in Switzerland. Some say they don't care because of the current situation. They understand the problems behind it and therefore let them being enrolled in the Swiss system. What you have to do in this regard with anybody joining anew your company, you have to look really on the nationality of the individual, as well as to look at in which country he is currently residing. That in case you onboard and start the employment, whether there are not maybe any implications out of it, that you have to pay maybe social security contributions or anything for sure in the country the individual is currently residing. They will check this out before you start the employment relationship. And rather, in case you won't know for sure, there will be a risk or there will be any costs associated to it, that you might check with the employee to change the start date and switch it to a later date. In this regard, you can as well deduct the tax at source, like he would if he had moved to Switzerland. The problem with it is just that he might really have to pay Austrian income tax on the income, as he had not been working and residing before in Switzerland. And therefore, there is no situation like the one before, where the person had been living and working already in Switzerland, and then the COVID-19 situation came up. Here, definitely, it would be good if you check it out with an Austrian tax consultant, whether that is a problem or whether you definitely will have to pay Austrian income taxes on the income. Otherwise, keep for the moment, pay the tax at source in Switzerland, deduct it, and then definitely check as soon as the individual can move to Switzerland, check about the taxation. Because what you have to keep in mind here as well is that the tax at source, which is applicable, depends on the canton where the individual is living. So for someone who has not already or is not already residing in Switzerland, you don't know really where or which cantonal tax tariff you need to use. What you definitely should do if you don't know which one you need to use because the individual has not been in Switzerland already, then just use the one from the legal entity he is employed with and where his workplace will be. So that at least that is the most likelihood that is the correct tax tariff. Unfortunately, I'm not in a situation right now that I can provide you with definitive answers, as first of all, we don't know how long the situation of COVID-19 will last. We don't know as well what each of the different authorities will do with it. We assume, and everybody said that it's their intention, that basically they will try not to complicate it more for employers as well as for employees, and then to make it as easy as possible in that situation. But we also don't know which kind of documentation or proof in the end to the different stakeholders we have to provide to that somebody, for example, has not been working in Switzerland, but abroad based on COVID-19. Because some of them just want to work from home. Still, even there is a possibility that they can come back to work at their workplace. I have no questions from you. So I assume now that everything is clear, or as clear as it is, as possible for the moment. In case you still have any questions, you can also send us an email and we see whether we can answer you that then. The next minute, I would like to just inform you about what you can see from us in the next few weeks. Still, we have our Global Mobility COVID-19 series ongoing. Next Tuesday, it will be at 11 a.m. again, and with the topic of what we have learned so far out of it. We have, in addition, our webinars, and maybe one which might be something for you on the 28th of May. There is one about business traveler in Switzerland, whether a work permit or a business visa is required. As well as there's on the 25th of June, something about the payroll. As well as maybe on the last one I would like to draw your attention to is on the 27th of August about best practice and assignments to Singapore, and on the 3rd of December in regard to China and Hong Kong. Still, we still have questions about assignments going abroad, and companies still prepare or already are again starting to prepare for the next move. Please feel free as well to contact us through our hotline, which is open from 9 to 11, and as well as visit us on our YouTube channel. I wish you a very good week and hope that you are all stay safe and healthy.